study disputes cytokine storm role in severe COVID-19. Previous studies have linked cytokine storm to severe adverse outcomes of COVID-19. However, a recent study suggested the condition having no role in those outcomes. Researchers found that patients with severe COVID-19 had lower cytokine levels compared to those with ARDS or septic shock. Dr. Peter Pickers, the study's lead author, said, "We were indeed surprised by the results of our study." According to the National Cancer Institute, cytokine storm occurs when the body releases excessive levels of cytokine. While the signaling protein helps the body heal, it also triggers inflammation to fight infections better. Inflammation is beneficial at the right levels and in a short time, but extended inflammation can lead to tissue damage. As a complication, cytokine storm can result in multiple organ failure. In the study, researchers studied 46 patients with COVID-19 and ARDS admitted to the ICU at Radboud University Medical Center. All patients were mechanically ventilated and treated between March 11 and April 27, 2020. The team measured the plasma levels of various cytokines, including interleukin-6, interleukin-8, and tumor necrosis factor. Then, they compared the measures to 51 patients who had ARDS and septic shock, 30 out-of-hospital cardiac arrest patients, and 62 patients who had multiple traumas. Data from non-COVID-19 patient groups was utilized as well. Results show that COVID-19 patients had lower levels on three measures than patients with ARDS and septic shock. The COVID-19 group had significantly lower levels of IL-6 and IL-8 than patients who had septic shock but without ARDS. The COVID-19 group had substantially lower levels of IL-8 than out-of-hospital cardiac arrest patients. But the COVID-19 group and trauma patients had no statistical difference in IL-8 levels. Also, the COVID-19 group, out-of-hospital cardiac arrest patients, and trauma patients had no difference in IL-6 levels. Yet, the cytokine TNF was higher among COVID-19 patients than the levels in trauma patients. Researchers clarify that the findings are preliminary and may not characterize cytokine storm. They recommended further studies to determine if anti-cytokine therapies are beneficial to COVID-19 patients. According to WebMD, the team is now investigating if treatments that lower cytokine levels will help COVID-19 patients. If so, they will study the long-term effects of these treatments on the immune system. Cytokine inhibitors and steroids must be assessed for extended suppression of the immune system.